Halo's influences on the industry as a whole are subtle, but countless.
Its most obvious being how it revolutionized first-person shooters on consoles. And in today's episode, we're going to be discussing the game design techniques that Bungie used to bring a genre that was previously made exclusively for basement PC nerds to the console mainstream. So spoiler warning from this point onwards for this 20-year-old game, and welcome to the anatomy of Halo. Bungie faced a lot of challenges to smoothly bring the FPS genre to consoles, specifically with user interface. And no, not UI, but user interface. How the user interfaces with the game. It's very broad. And what made Halo's interface unique for an FPS in 2001 was the fact it used a controller. And it cannot be overstated how much Halo did for modernizing twin-stick controller schemes for first-person shooters that were historically jank. Yes, there are simple surface-level changes that were made, like using aim assist to compensate for the decrease in control compared to PC, and haptic feedback or controller vibrations for that extra level of immersion. But the effects of having to develop for a controller interface had a knock-on effect on every single design decision made in Halo, from its mechanics to its level design. And Bungie did this so well, it changed the genre forever. Right, what I'm about to say might piss a few people off, but design-wise, the FPS genre is incredibly simple. Especially at the time of Halo's release. Looking at similar shooters at the time, their level designs just funneled the player down cramped corridors or wide open vistas, where the enemies just mindlessly bombard the player, making the core loop of this genre reactive gameplay. And we spoke about reactive gameplay in The Anatomy of Dark Souls Part 1, where the player is shown a stimulus and must immediately react to it. Moving from room to room, corridor to corridor, impulsively reacting to challenges that are currently T-posing towards them. And don't get me wrong, there is a place for this type of simple gameplay loop. It's nice to be presented a problem and having to MacGyver your way out of it, even if the solution is simply shoot them in face. The design problem is that pure reactive gameplay doesn't work very well on consoles, where the player is limited in how fast they can react by the interface that they're given, the controller. So if the main draw of this entire genre doesn't really work anymore, what else do you do? Well, Bungie had to find some other direction to take Halo to make it work on consoles. And they did this through tactics. The FPS genre may be simple, but it is incredibly volatile. Because of its simplicity, it's insanely easy to change one variable and just fuck everything up. Time to kill, ammo count, and player health need to be carefully balanced to craft a specific experience and tone. And because of the difficulty of developing an FPS for controllers, Bungie needed to craft a different tone with Halo, injecting tactical gameplay into its core loop. The way this was introduced to its mechanics was incredibly simple, but had a huge knock-on effect on everything to come. Like including a weapon limit. Instead of carrying an entire arsenal equipped for any and all situations, the player can only carry two weapons at any one time. And this weapon limit and reduced ammo demands the player changes weapons regularly, so they have to approach each arguably simple combat encounter in different tactical ways, based on the weapons they have access to, and scouring the environment and fallen foes for their precious arms. The developers carefully managing what weapons they give to craft ever-changing and unique tactical encounters for the player to overcome. But the single most impactful mechanical design decision was Halo's regenerating shield, which lets the player take damage and then heal it back up by staying out of the action for a short period of time. By using this regenerating shield system, it made up for the decreased accuracy that most players had with a controller, but also forced the player to retreat, flank, and plan their way to victory, adding so many different variables and tactical decisions that needed to be made in moment-to-moment gameplay just by simply altering one mechanic, because this was a huge departure from how the FPS genre handled healing at the time, and this, along with its two weapon restrictions, have been endlessly mimicked in the genre. But it's not just its mechanics that are designed for tactics. Halo also introduced a new way of looking at FPS level design. The original Halo's levels can feel incredibly barren, but that's due to a technical limitation of the time, being wide open vistas, tight corridors and complexes to save on that precious polygon real estate. Because every 3D model is made up of polygons, and the console is only able to render so many before it just catches on fire. The original Xbox could render a grand total of about 2 before it would explode. This means that every boulder, tree, or enemy had to be carefully placed as a tactical challenge for the player to use or overcome. Every single thing in its level designs has a purpose, as it's also expensive to render. But luckily, Bungie put resources towards one thing to elevate their level designs to the next tactical level, with verticality. By simply injecting verticality into its levels, small settlements, stones to perch upon, or hidden branching paths, it allows the player to plan approaches, flank, or even stealth up to enemies, killing them instantly, vastly changing the player's tactical options without altering the core mechanics. The player only has so much mechanical affect, shoot and move, but by simply taking this and injecting verticality, they then take the same core mechanics and completely change the tone, elevating what could have very easily been a simple corridor shooter to now a tactical masterclass through its level and mechanical design alone. But even with all of this tactical design, it wouldn't work if you could just hide behind one piece of cover and just shoot until everything was dead. Tactics would mean nothing without artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence in 2001, it was in its early stages, but Halo pushed the envelope to make its NPCs or non-player characters feel alive. But how did they do this? Well, it's all to do with its AI's deterministic behavior. Deterministic game AI is very simple in theory. The NPCs are given a specific set of rules and instructions and then act accordingly to what the player is doing. If the player is currently doing X and is Y distance away, then the AI will respond with Z. The AI is purely reacting to a specific stimuli from the player or other NPCs. To make this feel authentic, a lot of time has to go into crafting these specific reactions. The developers had to account for every single variable of player action, and then create a deterministic reaction for each specific NPC. Elites sidestep headshots or dodge incoming grenades. Grunts break ranks when they witness a slain elite. The Flood will hide around corners and wait until the player is engaged in combat to sliver their way out. Everything, from when to fire their weapons to flanking the player and using this same verticality against them, was all crafted in this deterministic model. The amount of care that must have gone into creating this AI system is outstanding for the time and makes it feel alive. But the artificial intelligence of this series has progressively got simpler and simpler. It's so arduous to develop, and as resources were pushed to prioritize polygonal detail and graphics, making the later games look so much better but feel empty. But what do you think? Do you believe as the series went on, the development resources were prioritized in the wrong places? And especially in 343's case, I would love to discuss this with you down below. I'd also love to make an episode about how game AI actually works and go a lot deeper into this topic. And if you would like to see that on The Escapist, just let us know down below. Everything in Halo Combat Evolved, from its mechanics, level designs, and AI, are all incredibly simple, yet so effective in encouraging tactical gameplay, and making it possible to bring an entire genre to the console mainstream, leading to so many other developers attempting to emulate the foundations Halo set. And if you enjoy the FPS genre, you owe a lot more to Halo than you might realize. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed today's episode, and I just want to say a big thank you to Escapist and my wonderful patrons for actually making this possible. And if you too do enjoy this series and you want to see more, I actually have my own channel with lots of similar content over there, and I can't wait to see you over there as well as on here on The Escapist. Thank you so much for the support, mate. I'll see you in the next one.